everyone, and welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let us begin with our prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I come before you asking for forgiveness of all of my sins, so that you may receive this prayer in your holy throne, thanking you always, O God, for the protection that you have given us through the night, and for this beautiful opportunity to face a new day with new strength and new hope, O God, thanking you for this opportunity to seek you one more time, to walk holding your hand, O God, to walk under your grace and your shelter. I thank you, O God, for this beautiful day, because it is also your blessed Sabbath, that we have the opportunity to be in your holy presence, to be with our brothers and sisters, and glorify your name in the services and all the activities that we are going to do today. I ask that you help us, O God, and that you fill us with your presence, and let us glorify your name and be filled and strengthened, O God, to continue in your path. O God, I ask that you also bless the two congregations of this day, that you fill them with joy and with strength, and that you help them in all their issues, their problems, their needs, O God, that today they may receive the answer to their prayers. Oh Lord, I present this devotional before you, asking that you bless all the hearts who will receive this word, and that through this word, oh God, you call us to be perfected, to be sanctified in you, oh God, so that we may really take advantage of this hope and this salvation that you have granted us, oh God, through sincere worship and obedience, O God. Let us live grateful lives for this blessed salvation that you have given us, O God. Thank you, O Lord, for everything, and all these things I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The devotional for today is titled, Settle Your Accounts, written by Migdalia Ayala, and translated by Nelson Bytus. This devotional comes from the book Mesa de Fe, page 46. Our biblical base is found in the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verses 6 to 17. So says the word of God. Then he said to me, "These words are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent his angel to show his servants the things which must shortly take place. Behold, I am coming quickly. Blessed is he who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book. Now I, John, saw and heard these things, and when I heard and saw, I fell down to worship before the feet of the angel who showed me these things. Then he said to me, See that you do not do that, for I am your fellow servant, and of your brethren the prophets, and of those who keep the words of this book. Worship God. And he said to me, Do not seal the words of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand. He who is unjust, let him be unjust still. He who is filthy, let him be filthy still. He who is righteous, let him be righteous still. He who is holy, let him be holy still. And behold, I am coming quickly, and my reward is with me, to give to everyone according to his work. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Blessed are those who do his commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter through the gates into the city. But outside are dogs and sorcerers and sexually immoral and murderers and idolaters and whoever loves and practices a lie. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify to you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, the bright and morning star. And the Spirit and the bride say, Come. And let him who hears say, Come. And let him who thirsts, come. Whoever desires, let him take the water of life freely. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of his word. Settle your accounts. Life is made in such a way that everything becomes calculations, accounts to find what we need and what we can acquire. The things that the world offers us have temporary benefits, since they are perishable. We have to consider what the Lord offers us by being participants in his eternal kingdom. Some sadly think that the kingdom of Christ will come to an end. They continue to live a superficial life, concerned only with material things and doing their own will. But that way, they are far from the kingdom of God and do not have their accounts settled. Others are struggling on the road with their own strength, dragging the memories of their past sins, living in anguish and without liberation. Those have not understood that when we come to Jesus, he forgives our sins and casts them into the depths of the sea. Brothers and sisters, let us live with the joy that salvation produces, taking advantage of all that we can enjoy on earth, with fear and longing for all that we will enjoy in eternity. Let us listen to the voice of Christ, who says, "Behold, I am coming soon." Let us prepare ourselves, worry about our spiritual life, and settle our accounts with God. Amen. The second coming of Jesus is an ever-present topic, but I feel like lately there has been an imperative calling from the Lord to remember this truth. The biggest and most recent has been the pandemic that we lived through these past years. Before it surfaced, it seemed like mankind was at the peak of scientific advancements, modernization, and just overall success, all while ignoring the Word of God, rejecting morality, and embracing a rampant lifestyle in search of satisfying selfish desires, which ultimately focused on glorifying ourselves, mankind. And it just took a microscopic, non-living organism to create chaos. And whether we acknowledged it or not, it showed us that we are nothing. In the end, we are helpless beings. Because we are only someone, we are only truly alive and have value and purpose in God, because he is the one who created us, who took us from the dust and breathed life into us. He is the one who gives us the sustenance, the resources, the shelter, the intelligence, the health, and so on and so on. Everything is because of him. So living a life focused on earthly matters, which are perishable, just doesn't make sense. Just as Job says, "Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there." We take nothing with us when we die, and yet we forget so easily and are so quickly drawn again to hold on to these things. But, O Lord, have mercy on us. Let this be our prayer, so that we may always remember what we are and what you have done to change our eternity. Let us always proclaim what Job finishes saying in that same phrase: "The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." No matter what our situation may be, let us always glorify the Lord, and let us instead focus on the eternal things and fight for them. Let us open our hearts to believe this word, this imminent coming. Let us surrender our lives in gratitude for the hope that we have received. Thank you, O Heavenly Father, for the fierce wake-up calls in which you show us your love and the desire you have to save us from death. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for tenderly watching over us and patiently waiting on us so we may be ready for your glorious coming. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your constant voice through sermons, songs, and various manifestations, all revealing to us that it is not a catchy theme to repeat, but an urgent call to seize the will of the flesh so that we may live by your truth, filled with your presence and with the joyous assurance of having settled accounts with the Lord Most High. Amen. All honor and glory to our Lord.
I have wrestled in the darkness of this lonely pilgrim land, raising strong and mighty fortresses that I alone command. But these castles I've constructed by the strength of my own hand are just temporary kingdoms on foundations made of sand. In the middle of the battle, I believe I finally found. I never know the thrill of victory till I'm willing to lay down all my weapons of defense and earthly strength. I'm laying down my arms and running helplessly to yours. I surrender all my silent hopes and dreams. For the price to follow costs me everything. I surrender all my human soul desires. If sacrifice treasure I obtain, if I measure my successes on a scale of earthly gain, then the focus of my vision is the status I attain. My accomplishments are worthless and my efforts are in vain, so I lay aside these trophies to pursue a higher crown. And should we choose somehow to use the life I willingly lay down, I surrender all the triumph, for it's only by your grace I relinquish all.
Thank you.
we have to work, struggle, and suffer for earthly things that do not fill our souls and in the end will all fade away, why not instead sacrifice what is needed to run the race that will gift us the imperishable crown? Brothers and sisters, in the name of the Lord, let us endure the temptation to be in control and instead surrender ourselves to God's will so that we may be found approved and receive the crown of life which the Lord has promised to those who love Him. Amen. And before finalizing this session, I kindly invite you to go over to our YouTube channel, SEC English Ministry, for our daily Bible readings so that we may find direction and life through His Word. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of His children, now and forever. Amen. Have a blessed Sabbath.